Is the Mediterranean diet the right kind of diet to help you reverse hormonal imbalances, lose weight, drop those pounds of excess weight, and start thriving? Or is it something that you need to be careful with? This is exactly what we're going to explore in my video today, so let's get started. Hey, hey, Yulia, Tarbath here, certified holistic nutritionist, helping you restore your hormonal balance, lose weight naturally, and create the body and life of your dreams. So, the Mediterranean diet, yay or nay? Before we dive into the subject today, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell notification, very important, so you never have to miss a single video from us. Now, if you are a health seeker, if you've been on a journey of restoring your health and balancing your hormones and balancing your weight, you've probably bounced from diet to diet in a search of finding that special answer that can finally help you get your health back. And you've probably come across the Mediterranean diet. So, what is the Mediterranean diet? Apart from the fact that it comes from the Mediterranean, so places like Greece, what is it? So it includes fruits and vegetables, grains, oils. So you will be consuming fats from oils. And it also includes some meat, some fish, some beans, and some dairy. And is this a truly healthy diet for you to implement? Now, I've got a question for you. Have you followed a Mediterranean diet? Is it something that you have considered for yourself? Let me know in the comment section. So there was a study that was called the Lyon study, and it looked at 600 people. So some people were given generic diet advice and other people were put on the Mediterranean diet. And what the study found was that their risk of a heart attack went down from 4% to 1% on the Mediterranean diet, which obviously shows that they achieved improvements with their health. But is it still a healthy diet for you to implement? Now, the thing with going Mediterranean and switching to a Mediterranean diet is that obviously you're going to start making improvements to your diet. And the moment you start adding more fruits and vegetables to your diet, you will start feeling better because fruits and vegetables are very health promoting. But what about all the other foods that also come with the Mediterranean diet? For example, oils. So the Mediterranean diet promoters will say that people in the Mediterranean are healthy because they consume the olive oil. However, this is absolutely not true. They're healthy not because they are consuming the olive oil. They're healthy because they're consuming more fruits and vegetables. And by the way, they're not that healthy anymore. And since the arrival of processed food and them not working as hard as they used to, they get modern diseases as well. So when it comes to the oil is a processed food. It's 100% fat. It is loaded with calories. So olive oil per se is not a healthy food. Olives, yes, but the moment you process olives and put it into oil, that becomes processed junk food. There is no 100% fat food that you will find in nature. Every food in nature comes with carbohydrates, with proteins, with nutrients, and olive oil is not loaded with nutrients at all. It's got zero nutrients other than fat. And when it comes to other foods like fish, and eggs and dairy, these foods are disease causing. So these are the foods that can cause you having diseases in the future. So if you are balancing your hormones, you definitely don't want to include dairy in your diet because dairy will throw your hormones out of balance. And studies showed that children who had 2 cups of dairy had their hormones go above what's normal. So if you've already got estrogen dominance, if you've already got excess of certain hormones, then you absolutely need to exclude dairy, and you don't want to be including dairy into your diet. When it comes to fish, well, fish has got a lot of toxicity, mercury from the sea, so we shouldn't be consuming products from the sea. And another thing with fish and meat is that it raises your levels of IGF-1, which causes inflammation and can lead to cancer. So animal foods, not only they can lead to cancer and promote inflammation in the body, they can also cause you to have too high cholesterol, so high cholesterol levels and high blood pressure. And then from there, it can also cause you insulin resistance because, again, of the saturated fat that is contained in the animal products. So instead of switching to the Mediterranean diet because it's like some kind of health promoting diet, you want to take what's necessary from the Mediterranean diet and leave the rest. So what's necessary is going to be fruits, vegetables, and plant whole foods. And that's the diet that will help you rebuild your health. And don't believe that Mediterranean diet myth that, you know, you have to eat Mediterranean diet to feel great, because the Mediterranean diet still contains the food that are not going to promote your health, are not going to help you reverse hormonal imbalances and lose weight. So you've probably looked into the Mediterranean diet because you have excess weight to lose. Well, guess what? I've got an awesome blueprint for you. So I've created a video that will show you how to lose 10 to 50 pounds of excess weight, eating all the carbs you care for and rebuilding your health as well. So click on the video that you will see on the screen, and I'll see you there.